Hey there, I'm Nico, your friendly neighborhood Cape Fox and Derail Valley modder. Today we're going to be talking about how to install mods for a Derail Valley simulator. First up, installing the mod loader, BepInEx. To install BepInEx, we'll first need to download it. We can find it on GitHub at github.com/BepInEx/BepInEx/releases/latest, or you can find the link in this video's description. Make sure that it says BepInEx version 5, and then we'll be looking for the zip file with x64 in the title. We'll go ahead and download that, which I've already done in advance, and open it up in File Explorer. You should see three files and a folder, just like this. We'll be copying those into Derail Valley's install folder. Let's go find that now. If you go to the Derail Valley library entry in Steam and click on the cog button, then go down under manage and click browse local files, that will open a File Explorer window open to the Derail Valley install directory. Now all we have to do to install BepInEx is to take everything that's in the archive and to drag it into the Derail Valley install directory, and those will copy over. Now, both directories have a changelog. You can skip it, you can replace it. It doesn't much matter. It's just a text file and it doesn't actually impact anything. So I'm gonna go ahead and skip it. And now, BepInEx is installed. We'll just need to run the game once. This will also verify that it is in fact installed. Once you get this far, you can go ahead and quit. And then we'll double check to make sure that everything is loaded properly. If we come into this BepInEx folder and then go to config, we should find now BepInEx config. This has general configuration for the mod loader itself. Now that we've verified that BepInEx is installed properly, we can install a code mod. To install a code mod, we'll first need to download it. The Derail Valley modding community uses Nexus mods to distribute the mods that we make. So if you go to nexusmods.com/derailvalley, you'll find all the mods that have been made for the game. We're going to use Skin Manager as an example mod. So we can go ahead to Files, Manual Download, and we will put that right on the desktop. And we can go ahead and double click to open that up in File Explorer. You'll know that it's a mod made for BepInEx if you see a BepInEx folder as the only folder in the archive. If you see anything other than that, then it is probably an old mod that still needs to be updated, and it predates Simulator back when the modding community was using Unity Mod Manager instead. Now that we've gotten this far, all we have to do is drag this folder into the Derail Valley install directory. See the last section for how to open that directory if you don't know, and we'll copy that in, and it should merge the folders. And we can now see that under BepInEx plugins, we now have Skin Manager and the assemblies are inside there. Now that we've installed the code mod, let's show you how to load some content. Mods like Skin Manager allow the player to load content made by other mod creators. Let's find a skin to load with Skin Manager. This one seems like a good one. Let's go to the Files and Manual Download. And we'll go ahead and download that to the desktop as well and open up the skin archive. Again, we'll know that this skin is up to date for Simulator and BepInEx if we see a lone BepInEx folder in the archive. And to install it, we drag and drop the folder into the Derail Valley install directory. Again, check the installing BepInEx section if you need to know how to find this directory. So if we look inside BepInEx now, we have a content folder with skins and LocoDM3, and then the Rio Grande skin that we just installed. Let's go ahead now and run Derail Valley and make sure that our skin is loaded properly. Let's bring out the comms radio and find the spawner, and we'll find a DM3, and we'll spawn that here, and we can see that it did load with the Rio Grande skin that we just installed. And so now we know that we've installed the skin properly. Next up, we'll demonstrate how to configure a mod. There are two ways of configuring a mod made for the BepInEx mod loader. I'll show you both, starting with the text editor way. If we go into the BepInEx folder inside the Derail Valley install directory, and then into config, we'll see again the global config that was generated the first time we ran Derail Valley after installing BepInEx. But we'll also see Skin Manager mod config, which was automatically generated the first time we ran Derail Valley after installing the Skin Manager mod. If we open that up, we'll see some options. Let's say, for instance, you didn't want to increase increase the anisotropic filtering. We could change this value to false, save the file, and now, when we load Derail Valley, the anisotropic filtering won't have been increased. The other way of configuring a mod is using the BepInEx configuration manager. That can be found on GitHub at github.com/bepinex/bepinex.configurationmanager/releases/latest, or you can click the link in the video description. Make sure that the version of configuration manager that you download is compatible with the version of BepInEx that you're using. We're using version 5.4.21, which should be compatible with this. We'll go ahead and download the archive. We'll again save it to the desktop, go back to our Derail Valley install directory, we'll open the archive we just downloaded, and again, we'll simply drag and drop the BepInEx folder to the install directory to install the mod. We can verify it's installed under the BepInEx plugins folder. Configuration Manager doesn't use a folder for its assemblies and related files, so it just puts them directly in the plugins folder. It still works just the same. Now, we'll go ahead and run Derail Valley again, and we'll see how we can configure mods from within the game using this plugin. The default keybind for Configuration Manager is F1. That brings up this menu, and we can see here the configuration for Skin Manager. Let's go ahead and re-enable increased anisotropic filtering. We'll close that and just double check it is indeed enabled now. That's all it takes. That said, the default shortcut for Configuration Manager conflicts with Derail Valley's own keybinds. Let's see if we can change that. We go into config and find the Configuration Manager config file. We'll open that up, and here we can find the Show Configuration Manager option. We'll go ahead and change that to F10 and save. Then, when we run Derail Valley again, we'll see that it uses the new keybind and no longer conflicts with Derail Valley's keybinds. Now when I press F1, nothing happens, but when I press F10, it brings up the Configuration Manager. Now there's one last thing you ought to know if you're going to be using mods made for BepInEx, and that's how to disable mods. Disabling mods is pretty simple using BepInEx. We simply come to the Derail Valley install directory, find the winhttp.dll file, and we'll rename it. Let's give it a different extension. We'll give it .bak to know that we've backed this up for later use. If we run Derail Valley again, we'll see that no mods have been loaded. We'll verify this two ways. First, we'll verify that the Configuration Manager window no longer opens, and then we'll load the save and ensure that skins are no longer applied to the DM3. So I'm going to go ahead and press F10. And we can see that the Configuration Manager window is no longer opening. But just to be doubly sure, let's load the save file and ensure that the skin is no longer applied to the DM3. We'll spawn another DM3, and we'll see that the default skin is loaded. There you have it, how to install BepInEx, code mods, content, configure your mods, and temporarily disable your mods. Hopefully this has been insightful and has helped you with your Derail Valley modding experience. If you liked the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and the algorithm thinks you'd like to watch this video next.